Welcome to a lesson on solving recurrence relations. A recurrence relation is a recursive definition without the initial conditions. For example, if we consider the Fibonacci numbers or Fibonacci sequence, defined recursively by f sub n equals f sub n minus 1 plus f sub n minus 2, this equation is a recurrence relation. And if we include the initial conditions f sub 0 equals 0 and f sub 1 equals 1, we have a recursive definition. Converting recursive definitions to closed formulas is called solving a recurrence relation, and there are three main ways to solve recurrence relations. The first is inspection, in which we write down the first few terms beginning with the initial conditions and look for a pattern to find a closed formula. For example, we may recognize the sequence as arithmetic or geometric. Number two is telescoping. This is when many of the terms of the sequence cancel out when adding the equations of the sums or differences of terms. If we know the sum of the non-canceled terms, we can find a closed formula. And number three is the characteristic root technique. We can use this technique when the recurrence relation can be written in the form of a sub n plus alpha times a sub n minus 1 plus beta times a sub n minus 2 equals 0. To get this form, we do have to set one side of the recurrence relation equal to 0 to determine the value of alpha and beta. Once we determine alpha and beta, we can form the characteristic polynomial, which is x squared plus alpha x plus beta, which if we set equal to 0, gives the characteristic equation. And if r sub 1 and r sub 2 are two distinct roots of the characteristic polynomial, meaning solutions to the characteristic equation, then the solution to the recurrence relation is a sub n equals a times r sub 1 to the power of n plus b times r sub 2 to the power of n, where a and b are constants determined by the initial conditions. So to find a and b, we have to use the initial conditions to set up and solve a system of equations. And if r sub 1 happens to equal r sub 2, meaning we have a repeated root or only one root, then the closed formula is a sub n equals a times r sub 1 to the power of n plus b times n times r sub 2 to the power of n. Notice how the second term on the right here has a factor of n when we have a repeated root or only one root. And now let's take a look at an example of the method of inspection. Let's solve the recurrence relation a sub n equals a sub n minus 1 plus 3 with a sub 0 equal to 4. We begin by writing out the terms of the sequence. A sub 0 equals 4. A sub 1 is equal to 4 plus 3, which is 7. A sub 2 is equal to 7 plus 3, which is 10. A sub 3 is equal to 10 plus 3, which is 13, and so on. Notice the terms of the sequence are increasing by 3, which indicates we have an arithmetic sequence with a common difference of 3. We know if we have an arithmetic sequence, the common difference d is equal to a sub n minus a sub n minus 1, which using the first two terms, we can verify 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. We're also given a sub 0 equals 4. Because we have an arithmetic sequence where a sub 0 is equal to 4, the closed formula is a sub n equals a sub 0 plus d times n, which gives us a sub n equals 4 plus 3n. This is the solution to the recurrence relation. And now let's consider the method of telescoping. Given the recurrence relation a sub n equals a sub n minus 1 plus n with a sub 0 equal to 4. We have a sub 0 equals 4, a sub 1 equals 4 plus 1, which is 5, a sub 2 is equal to 5 plus 2, which is 7, a sub 3 is equal to 7 plus 3, which is 10, and so on. Notice here the difference between the terms is n, and therefore let's look at several differences. A sub 1 minus a sub 0 is 5 minus 4, which is 1. A sub 2 minus a sub 1 is 7 minus 5, which is 2. A sub 3 minus a sub 2 is 10 minus 7, which is 3, and so on. If we find n differences, the last difference would be a sub n minus a sub n minus 1, which we can see from the pattern is equal to n. And now using the method of telescoping, we will add all these equations together. Notice on the left, many of the terms simplify out. We have a sub 1 minus a sub 1, a sub 2 minus a sub 2, a sub 3 minus a sub 3, and so on. On the left, when adding, the only terms left are negative a sub 0 plus a sub n. This gives us negative a sub 0 plus a sub n equals the sum on the right, which is the sum of the integers from 1 through n, or 1 plus 2 plus 3, all the way out to plus n. And now we will solve this equation for a sub n. which gives us a sub n equals a sub 0 plus the sum of the integers from 1 through n. Well, we know a sub 0 is equal to 4, and we know from our previous work we can determine the sum of the integers from 1 through n because this is a sum of an arithmetic sequence. So we can find this sum using the reverse and add method, which indicates the closed formula is a sub n equals 4, which is a sub 0, and then plus the sum of the integers from 1 through n, which is n divided by 2 times the quantity n plus 1. And I did show the method of reverse and add below, which we can use to determine the sum of an arithmetic sequence, where we have s equals the sum of the integers from 1 through n, and for the second equation, we reverse the order of the sum, and then we add the two equations together, which gives us 2s equals a sum of n, n plus 1s, which we can write as 2s equals n times the quantity n plus 1, dividing both sides by 2. We have s equals n divided by 2 times the quantity n plus 1. And now let's take a look at an example of the characteristic root technique. We can use this technique when the recurrence relation can be written in the form of a sub n plus alpha times a sub n minus 1 plus beta times a sub n minus 2 equals 0. So as an example, let's solve the recurrence relation a sub n equals 3 times a sub n minus 1 plus 10 times a sub n minus 2 with a sub 0 equals 4 and a sub 1 equals 1. The first step is to write the recurrence relation in the correct form so that we can identify alpha and beta, which means we subtract 3 times a sub n minus 1 and subtract 10 times a sub n minus 2 from both sides of the equation, which gives us a sub n minus 3 times a sub n minus 1 minus 10 times a sub n minus 2 equals 0. Now we know alpha is equal to negative 3 and beta equals negative 10. From here we form the characteristic equation using alpha and beta. The characteristic equation is x squared plus alpha x plus beta equals 0, which in our case is x squared minus 3x minus 10 equals 0. And now we solve. In this case, we can easily solve by factoring, which results in the solutions x equals 5 and x equals negative 2, which means a general solution is a sub n equals a times r sub 1 to the power of n plus b times r sub 2 to the power of n, which in our case is a sub n equals a times the nth power of 5 plus b times the nth power of negative 2. And now to finish, we need to determine the values of a and b, which we can find by setting up and solving a system of equations using the initial conditions of a sub 0 equals 4 and a sub 1 equals 1. To find a sub 0, we substitute 0 for n into the general solution, which gives us the equation a times the 0 power of 5 plus b times the 0 power of negative 2 equals 4. And then to find a sub 1, we substitute 1 for n, which gives us the equation a times the first power of 5 plus b times the first power of negative 2 equals 1. Simplifying, our two equations are a plus b equals 4 and 5a minus 2b equals 1. We now need to solve this as a system of equations to determine the values of a and b, which will give us our final solution. Of course, there's many ways to solve the system of equations. I'm going to go ahead and use an augmented matrix, where the first row 1, 1, 4 represents the equation a plus b equals 4, and the second row of 5, negative 2, 1 represents the equation 5a minus 2b equals 1. Next, we write the augmented matrix in reduced row echelon form. The first row indicates a equals 9 sevenths. The second row indicates b equals 19 sevenths. And now to finish, we substitute a and b into our closed formula. This gives us a sub n equals 9 sevenths times the nth power of 5 plus 19 sevenths times the nth power of negative 2 for the closed formula or solution to the recurrence relation. Before we go, I also want to mention we will not consider the case when the solutions to the characteristic equation are complex, nor when we have higher order polynomials for characteristic equations. For example, if we had the recurrence relation a sub n equals 2 times a sub n minus 1 plus a sub n minus 2 minus 3 times a sub n minus 3, the characteristic equation would be x cubed minus 2x squared minus x plus 3 equals 0. Also, we will only discuss linear or homogeneous recurrence relations with constant coefficients in the form of a sub n plus alpha times a sub n minus 1 plus beta times a sub n minus 2 equals 0. The homogeneous refers to the fact that the right side of the equation is 0. When it is non-zero, it is referred to as non-homogeneous. I hope you found this helpful.